all welcome. You're on the Nation at 5. I'm Anand Narasimha. Ladies and gentlemen, there is plenty that's happening in the neighborhood, especially in Pakistan, which is a huge cause for worry because it just looks like what is quote-unquote a democratically elected government has been brought to its knees by radicals, fundamentalists, and outfits that are being backed openly by terrorist outfits like the Taliban, the Jaish, and of course the Lashkar-e-Taiba. News is coming through about Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan head Saad Rizvi. Well, plenty of updates coming through there. The TLP chief Saad Hussain Rizvi has been released from jail, and that's what we're given to understand. So the Home Minister of Pakistan just about a week ago had called the outfit under invoking the clauses of terrorism and called him nothing short of a terrorist. Now he's been released after negotiations. Imran Khan's speech, which was made yesterday, was an indication that there would be some amount of consensus that would be reached. And it has said that the aim of the Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan and the government is the same. What is the word that's coming through? And that Saad Rizvi has been instructed very clearly not to speak against the establishment. So this is even as, and we go across to Tejinder Singh Sodhi joining us live, even as we're getting to understand that the Pak National Assembly has actually moved a resolution to send back the French envoy to go out and reach out to all the Muslim nations and to try and push this entire fundamentalist Islamist agenda. Yes, Tejinder.
Yes, Anand, you rightly pointed out. Yes, Anand, you rightly pointed out that the entire system in Pakistan is in a disarray right now. You see, it seems that the Imran Khan Niazi has already surrendered to the radical Islamists by accepting all their demands. We know that just a few days ago, the Interior Minister of Pakistan, Sheikh Rashid, had openly said that Pakistan is banning Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan under various sections of the Terror Act. And now last night what we have been told by the sources that a marathon meeting, four rounds of a marathon meeting that lasted for 12 hours was held between the representatives of the Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan and the representatives of the Pakistani government. And in fundamental Pakistan, government has accepted all the demands of Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan. Their main demand was to make sure that Pakistan expels the French ambassador from Pakistan. And today, you see, first it was the Interior Minister of Pakistan who gave a statement saying that the Pakistan National Assembly would move a resolution wherein they will demand the expulsion of the French ambassador. But right now what we have been told by the sources that the special session of the Pakistani National Assembly is going on right now. The resolution has already been moved to expel the French ambassador from Pakistan. And also Saad Hussain Rizvi, who is the mastermind who had given the deadline of April 22 to Pakistan to expel the French ambassador, is having an upper hand because all his demands are being met. So clearly a surrender by Imran Khan Niazi to the radical Islamists in Pakistan. Yes, Anand.
Well, not just a surrender by Imran Khan Niazi, but this is actually like saying that their intentions are the same. That's the other part that you brought to us, and we'll try and flash that out. I just want to take your comments before we go to our guests. The other aspect you're saying, even as the Pak National Assembly is in session, there is a resolution that's been moved to send the envoy back, all Muslim nations to be contacted, and European nations to be apprised of the sensitivity of the matter. What kind of sensitivity are they talking about? What this is the kind of movement that the Pak Assembly is now going to call, is going to be following the diktats of outfits that are radical, they are fundamentalist, they are Islamist in their bent, and they've been backed by other terror outfits like the Lashkar, Jaish, and the Taliban, Tejinder.
See, Anand, if you see the timeline in Pakistan, we have seen how this the blasphemy law has been misused against minorities in Pakistan, and now it seems that Pakistan wants the European nations to have this blasphemy law. You see, the resolution which has been moved in the Pakistani National Assembly, as you rightly pointed out, there are three main points which is being discussed. That is, French envoy to be sent back, all non-Muslim nations to be contacted on this. And one thing which you call, you can call it funny, is that Pakistan would appraise the European nations of the sensitivity of the matter. The sensitivity is regarding the blasphemy law that has been enacted in Pakistan, wherein anybody who is criticizing Islam or the Islam's prophets, they are punished, they are given the...
No, Pakistan is going to decide. Pakistan is going to decide how France has a vibrant democracy and the French need to behave, and Pakistan is going to decide that. And that's what the resolution that's being passed in Pakistan. Who are Pakistan? This is not a democracy. This is like an ultra-arty, rabid, radical outfit, radicalized nation, which is now, because of the fact that it was a haven for terrorists, is now being driven by those who have Islamist and terrorist intentions and nothing but that. Thank you for your input, Tejinder. I just want to go across to Amjad Ayub Mirza joining us, BOK political activist, and also Captain Alok Bansal, director of India Foundation. Alok ji, good evening. My first question to you is, this is what? We don't say radical elements in Pakistan anymore, we just say radicalized Pakistan. Imran Khan is saying that the intent of the establishment or the government and TLP is the same.
Undoubtedly, his ministers are saying that the Prime Minister and the TLP wants the same, objectives are same, the means being adopted are different, thereby actually sanctifying what TLP has been doing. And TLP, right from its inception, has been getting away with this sort of violence and this sort of holding the government to ransom. If you remember, first time when there was a minor change in the electoral law, they had held the Islamabad Rawalpindi main expressway, actually they had blocked it. And again, subsequently, when Asia BP was acquitted, they again had turned violent. The founder of TLP, the Khadim Rizvi, Saad Rizvi's father, actually died under mysterious circumstances. And now, the violence has been so pervasive, all pervasive, that there have been actually chaos. In fact, initially they said they have banned TLP, but now they are negotiating with TLP. They have virtually surrendered the state sovereignty in front of TLP. And TLP has been getting away. Now, what is important is that TLP is actually a Sunni Bareilly party, and which has very, very fiercely sectarian agenda. It has actually indicated anti-Shia rhetoric. It has been vehemently anti-Ahmadiyya. And this is this sort of violence that they are perpetrating is actually dividing the polity in Pakistan. And this sort of radicalized society that Pakistan has turned into, we will see greater violence. We will see violence between different sects, different subsects, and that is what we are seeing.
No, and this is not in the name of Islam. In the name of Islam, this is rabid radicalism, and this is Islamist bents, and these are terrorist outfits that were actually backing the TLP on the streets. Amjad Ayub Mirza, even someone like a Kamar Javed Bajwa looks helpless. So is what? That the army is also accepting that there are radical elements within the army and the police. The army and police are also radicalized. That is something to that effect is what Imran Khan said in his speech yesterday.
Thank you very much for having me. The thing, basically what we should realize is that all through this demonstration and protest, the army has not issued a single statement. They have been in the background. And I can now confirm that this Tehreek-e-Labbaik, Pakistan, this all disturbances that we have seen over the past few days have been engineered by the poor commander of the 4th Corps, poor commander Lahore, Lieutenant General Abdul Aziz, who was given the task in November 2020 to incite Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan to create a violent political unrest in Pakistan, and for the army to use this as a pressure group against Imran Khan. And this Abdul, at the moment, the DG of Rangers Punjab and the DG and the IG Punjab and the DG of Punjab Police are all taking direct instructions from Lieutenant General Abdul Aziz, who is stationed in Lahore. Now, this development is very, very dangerous, because the government has hastily banned this organization. Then yesterday, as I informed through your channel, that the session for parliament was going on, but suddenly the speaker of the assembly adjourned the session and said that now the session will convene on Thursday. But today is Tuesday, and they have come back at an emergency session to discuss. This is all dramebazi, you know. They Pakistan. The government of Pakistan, the civilian government of Pakistan, and the military might of Pakistan, they are all on the same page when it comes to sponsoring and harboring and nurturing terrorist outfits inside Pakistan.
No, but the larger issue is that this is like all of Pakistan, the way they took to the streets and what has been orchestrated on the streets of Lahore and in Islamabad and also some of the other regions. Even Muzaffarabad, we saw such these protests spill over into. It just shows that how radicalized and how fundamentalist the whole bent has become. And you are saying that an Islamist agenda is a common agenda. Although the means are different or the methods are different, the ultimate goal is the same. What is the difference between Imran Khan and Saad Rizvi and the Jaish and the Taliban? Then they're all one and the same. That's what it looked like. We got more inputs. Big revelation on CNN News 18. Clear proof of Imran Khan losing control. A Pakistan minister has been caught on tape. A Pakistan sitting minister has been caught on tape abusing Imran Khan and the army. Pak Minister Syed Ali Haider Zedi, his audio has been leaked and he says Imran Khan is not capable of handling anything. He also says earlier Imran Khan got only one seat for 20 years. How is it that he suddenly got full majority and won the elections?
इसका बाप था ना टीएलपी वाला खादिम हुसैन रिजवी, ये उसकी औलाद है। अब देखना ये कैसे हीरो बनेगा, इस तरह पैदा करते हैं नया नया हीरो ही। अब ये जो उसका बेटा है, नोबडी कैन न्यू हु दिस वाज, ना उसकी शक्ल का, आज देखो हर जगह पाकिस्तान में उसकी शक्ल, नया लीडर पैदा हुआ है। भैया हमें तो बहुत मजा आता है जब मैं डिस्ट्रक्शन देखता हूँ तो आई फील विंडिकेटेड कि जो मैं लोगों को कहता था वो इट्स सैड बट इट्स ट्रू गवर्नमेंट हैज फेल्ड. This puppet government has completely failed. Modi ki wale dekh rahe honge, kahenge dekho humko kuch karne ki zarurat nahi hai, country is on a self-destructive path.
Country is on a self-destructive path, the sitting minister saying this. Now look at what they have done. They're going to hurt themselves diplomatically. France is an important voice within the FATF and they are now ousting a French ambassador. You have Shah Mahmood Qureshi who's there with the Muslim world and trying to make a big pitch. The UAE is not going to take kindly to this. There is huge amount of resistance to the kind of politics that's being tried between Pakistan, especially its liaisoning with China and Turkey, and also Russia coming into the play. Captain Alok Bansal.
Undoubtedly, Pakistan is an actually dire straits. And here I want to highlight one point which I think Ayub Saab said, that Lieutenant General Abdul Aziz is the mastermind. We need to understand that Kamar Javed Bajwa has a problem as far as TLP is concerned. As far as TLP is concerned, his ability to deal with TLP is severely restricted because he has often been accused of his Ahmadiyya leanings. His wife is a practicing Ahmadiyya, his in-laws are buried in Rabwa. And TLP came into being under the project of opposing Ahmadiyya. If you remember, TLP is actually a political party of the Tehreek-e-Labbaik Ya Rasulullah. That is, I am their prophet. So it is actually a party which is ostensibly created to support the prophet. And so as a result, the whole agenda of this party has been blasphemy and issues like this. Now, Kamar Javed Bajwa, because of his Ahmadiyya insinuations, finds it difficult to tackle TLP head on. And now the fact that Abdul Aziz, who is actually a radicalized general, if you actually look at his photo, look at his appearance with all that bearded face of his, he is one of those radicalized generals, that actually shows that even within the army now you are seeing dissensions, which is a very, very serious issue. Now, as it is, if you are asking French ambassador to go back, I'm sure France is not going to appoint another ambassador. You are actually breaking your relations with European Union, with the Western world. Mm. At a time when Pakistan needs the Western capital, its actually finances are in deep stress because they have been borrowing money, IMF programs and have been going on, adjustments have been taking place, and they have been borrowing more to pay back what they had borrowed earlier. And at that stage, any snap with European Union will be catastrophic for they have been given a GSP plus preferential treatment by the European Union as far as their textile products are concerned, which is the mainstay of Pakistan's industry, which is the mainstay of Pakistan's exports.
Right.
Now, we've already had extremists from the Deobandi Wahhabi dispensation. Now you have extremists from the Bareilvi dispensation. So virtually the entire Sunni spectrum has been actually radicalized.
Mm.
In retaliation, you already have Shia groups like Tehreek-e-Zafari, Zafari and Sepah-e-Muhammad, etc.,
yeah,
which are actually going to retaliate. So we have a very, very serious problem in Pakistan, and as a result, Pakistan is trying to look for a via media. Now, Imran Khan has said that he will visit Saudi Arabia.
Mm.
He's trying to garner support from Islamic nations so that he could project it as Islam versus the rest fight, which is not happening because no other Islamic nation has actually taken any cognizance of this. Nobody has asked any French ambassador to go. It's only Pakistan where this drama is going on. So I don't think so either Qureshi or Imran Khan is going to succeed in this particular issue.
No, it's not even succeeding. It's just about what is going to happen in this entire region, because the Pakistanis are actively trying to disrupt situations in Afghanistan because they have given the sanctuary to the Taliban. You're saying that all the various sects of the Sunni, sects itself and subsects of Sunnis, they're all now involved into highly radicalized narratives and narrative pitches. You have the likes of Fazlur Rahman, who's a moderate, also coming out and backing a radical outfit like Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan. Now, we got more inputs coming through. Shah Mahmood Qureshi is currently on the UAE visit, and he's managed to extend the date of loan repayment to the UAE. But according to well-informed sources, his next visit is going to be Turkey and then Iran. And he'll try and ask for support of coming out of the FATF grey list. Amjad Ayub Mirza, what does this mean for the region? Is there a new axis that is brewing, which is Russia, China, Turkey and Pakistan? And where are going to be the OIC in the midst of all of this? Because there is a clear effort by Turkey and Malaysia to divide the OIC, to split the OIC. And Pakistan is...
That now the Sunni Muslim across the spectrum are on one page, and they're already. Is the political wing of Taliban? I'm allowed to say.